olfactory fossa depth, a must-know for endoscopic sinus surgeon. What is olfactory fossa? The olfactory fossa is the part of piriform plate. These are shallow depressions which is located within the ethmoid bone in the anterior canal fossa, and it harbors the olfactory bulb of the olfactory nerve as shown in the figure. So the floor of the olfactory fossa is formed by the medial lamella of the piriform plate, which is bordered laterally by the lateral lamella as shown by the yellow arrow, and medially by the perpendicular plate as shown by the yellow arrow as shown in the CT scan figure. The depth of the olfactory fossa is very important, so it is determined by the length of the lateral lamella of the piriform plate. But for measurement of the depth of the olfactory fossa, Kerr's classification is commonly used, and it measures the depth of the olfactory fossa. What is the history of Kerr's classification? This classification was first described in 1962 by Friedrich Kerr, a Croatian physician and who later became the professor of medicine at the University of Zagreb. So what are the types of Kerr's classification? There are basically three types of Kerr's classification as per the length of the olfactory fossa or depth of the olfactory fossa. Type 1 is the 1 to 3 mm deep as shown in the figure below. And in this, the lateral lamella is short and the ethmoid lobe and piriform plate are almost in the same plane. Whereas in the type 2, which is in the most common, and it is nearly about 4 to 7 mm deep and the lateral lamella is longer. Whereas in type 3, it is 8 to 16 mm deep and the ethmoid lobe lies significantly above the piriform plate as shown in the figure below. So, how to calculate the olfactory fossa depth in the CT scan? In the CT scan, it is the coronal view which is normally taken for measuring the olfactory fossa depth and calculating it. For this, the position of piriform plate and ethmoid lobe are calculated relative to the orbital floor as shown by the infraorbital foramen, which is basically a plane passing through the two foramen is used, and it is shown in the figure and which is shown by the yellow arrow. Next is the two reference points are chosen at the skull base, and these reference points are the point of articulation of the medial ethmoid groove with lateral lamella of the piriform plate, which is abbreviated as MERP, and the lowest point on the piriform plate, which is abbreviated as CP, and these two are shown by the yellow arrow in the CT scan figure. Next, for the measurement, the vertical height from the MERP and the vertical height from the CP to the horizontal plane through the infraorbital foramen are measured on each side. So, the lateral lamella of piriform plate is calculated by subtracting CP height from the MERP height as shown in the bracket, that is MERP minus CP is equivalent to LLCP. This CT scan coronal section shows the type 1 Kerr's on the left side, which is 1 to 3 mm as shown by the yellow arrow. Similarly, in the left side it is type 2 Kerr's, which is 4 to 7 mm as shown by the yellow arrow. This is again the coronal section of the CT scan showing the type 2 Kerr's on the left side, which is near about 8 to 16 mm in height. So this is the chart shown in this figure, which shows the different height of the olfactory fossa as per the Kerr's classification in the different countries worldwide. As per this classification, in Germany and India, in Turkey, the type 2 is more common. Likewise in Nepal, USA, Philippines and Egypt, the type 1 is more common as shown in the figure. So what kind of Kerr's types or olfactory fossa depth is most common in Nepali population? As per the different study performed in the Nepal, mainly in the Dhulkhel Hospital and Kathmandu Medical College, the type 1 is the most common olfactory fossa depth or Kerr's classification in Nepali population with near about 86%. Though there are advantages, but there are also certain fallacies in the Kerr's classification. Likewise, in measurement, in type 1, it is 1 to 3 mm, type 2 is the 4 to 7 mm, and type 2 is the 8 to 16 mm. So, there is 1 mm deficit in each type as we move from one to another type. So, it is difficult to mention in which type, if there is the 3.5 mm height or 7.5 mm height, or the height is between 7 to 8 mm, or if the height is between 3 to 7 mm. So, this is the main fallacies of the Kerr's classification. So, apart from the fallacies of the Kerr's classification, there are certain uses of Kerr's classification. According to Kerr's, the more the height of lateral lamella of piriform plate, the greater the risk of iatrogenic injury during endoscopic sinus surgery. Therefore, Kehl's classification suggests that if there is a type 3 classification, then there is a chance of the risk during endoscopic sinus surgery for iatrogenic injury of the olfactory fossa.